Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and this is my first video in a series of my videos talking about games and the way they tell stories. In this video, I'm going to be talking about the Half-Life series and how they tell their stories. Obviously, it's pretty revolutionary game in the way that it does this, and I think this method of storytelling is really something that only Valve has been able to pull off really well with Half-Life and Half-Life 2 and Half-Life 2 Episode 1 and Episode 2. The only other company that I think does really well with this kind of method of storytelling is Irrational Games, but they have their own nuances to their storytelling, and that actually BioShock 2, well, I don't know too much about BioShock 2, but BioShock and BioShock Infinite are the games that I'll be talking about in the next video. This video I want to talk specifically about Half-Life and the way they tell it. The difference between Half-Life and BioShock is that the main character is mute. He doesn't talk at all. But the way they tell their stories is very similar. There are no cutscenes. And Half-Life is unique in that the story moments are very rare and it doesn't happen that much. Most of the story is told, not told, but kind of just, you expect to get the story just by exploring the environment. And just kind of chancing upon people, characters in the game, non-playable characters, and just kind of listening to them or passing by them. So most of the story in the game is something that you just kind of experience as a player, all in first-person perspective. And you always have the ability to control your character throughout the entire game, except maybe very ending of Half-Life and Half-Life 2. There's a kind of a brief few moments there where you don't have control of the controller, but you don't need to because the game has ended, you know. But what's unique about Half-Life is that the story moments, what I'm referring as story moment in these types of game, is when you're in a room and there's a character talking to you, and there's not much to do other than listen to that character because that room is a confined space, so you don't have anywhere to go and nothing to do but to just go around and look around. Those are the kind of the story moments, or, you know, moments when you don't really have a control of your character. They're very, very rare in Half-Life 2, or Half-Life 1, for that matter, any of the Half-Life games. Very rare. The times you meet up with a different character are very brief. So in that manner, the great thing about Half-Life is it's pretty much all about gameplay, all about exploring. And the way that, you know, you get the sense of this mystery, you get the sense of loneliness. It's a very silent game for most of the time. You don't have any characters talking to you for most of the game. Maybe that's not true for Half-Life 2 Episode 1. But most of the time, it's pretty much silent dialogue-wise. I mean, you still got explosions and gunshots and alien groans and moans going on. But dialogue-wise, it's a very silent series. And so you have to kind of get the story by experiencing it, and it's a great idea, and really Valve pulls it off really well. People have been able to write up story facts that kind of just delve into the mythos of Half-Life, and it's just like this, the timeline of Half-Life is pretty amazing stuff to read into and to discuss. But that's the drawback of this type of storytelling, I think. While you never lose control, you can never fully figure out the full sense of the story. You have to kind of figure out piece by piece. It's like a puzzle. And even then, you're still left with a lot of mystery. And because the times that you meet up with characters that talk to you are so infrequent, it's really hard to just be really attached to any of the characters, except the one that you spend a lot of time with, which is Alex Vance. Which is particularly why Alex Vance as a character is someone that you grow so attached to and so emotionally invested into. And she's that character that's like a companion that is so awesome. I fell in love with Alex Vance right away just because she's like the most human character in the game. You talk with her, she talks to you so much. She has amazingly human facial expressions. Revolutionary for his time, I think. Some games have yet to mimic that perfectly other than products of like Irrational Games. So that's Irrational Games. I'm going to talk about that in the next video. But Half-Life, it's the drawback is there. The limitation of the story is just that we don't really, we can't really form too much out of it. The fact that Gordon Freeman is mute, in a sense, I can understand why they did that. It kind of, you know, you are Gordon Freeman, so you, revolutionary for his time, you know, it's, you feel like Gordon Freeman, you know, you can really invest yourself into this universe. You feel lonely when it gets so silent, and the environment you explore is so wide, and you're like figuring out, how do I get from here to there when there's this humongous gap and then this toxic waste over here that I cannot touch? Like, what the heck do I do? You know, it's that kind of loneliness that is amazing in Half-Life. But overall, story-wise, like, the story of Half-Life can be said in, like, three sentences. If that, you know, like, aliens, your scientific experiment causes a portal to happen, aliens pop in, and then the government wants to shut down Black Mesa, so government troops fall in. Gordon Freeman, you want to escape this lab facility that's gone haywire. You fight a lot of aliens, you fight a lot of troops, and you escape. But before you escape, you go into this alien vortex, you defeat the alien, and this being known as G-Man, you know, that's the story. It's a very simple story when you just kind of describe it like that, and that's because it is. Half-Life, anyway. Half-Life 2, it gets a little more complex, but you know what I mean? Like, the complexity of the plot is because not much is told to you. You just kind of have to figure things out. Maybe that's the strength. But to me, it feels like a weakness because it's a story where I don't quite get it. I don't understand what's going on, and there's no, like, I think story-wise, Episode 2 did the best, simply because it had Alex Vance as a character that you were attached to. It had a lot of chatter, and story-wise, it kept things moving, and then the emotional climax at the end, which is why people are so anticipating continuation of the Half-Life series. But it's a storytelling that I think needs evolution. And in this regard, storytelling-wise, there's a lot to learn for Valve from someone like Irrational Games, which is the BioShock series is the next game I'll talk about in the next video.